What is going on, my fellow outlaws? Outlaw Gary here, and today's an exciting day because we are talking about the future of Red Dead Online. Of course, if you guys do enjoy the video, be sure to drop it a like. If you are new around here, hit that subscribe button, click that little bell, stay notified, and big thank you to every single one of you that has been coming back every day to watch all the Outlaw Gary videos. It's been absolutely heartwarming to see all of you guys coming back every day to the Outlaw community and just showing the mad amounts of support with the brand new update that we just received with the new Outlaw Pass and so much more. Of course, there's something brewing. Now, as you guys know, I am the biggest hype man for Red Dead Online and Red Dead Redemption 2. Like, I am like the guy that people can go to that like, oh my God, have some faith. You know, like that's me. That's always been my MO about Red Dead Redemption 2 and Red Dead Online. And in general for Rockstar, I feel like I have a self-titled position to just ensure that we remain positive, because I'm a pretty positive dude. And luckily enough for us, there was a pretty big leak recently when it comes to Red Dead Online with a Halloween update. Now, I know what you're thinking. Garrett, we're very far away from Halloween, but are we really? It's only about 2 months away, and October's like literally around the corner, and there might be some bigger stuff in the works. So let's talk about it. As you guys know, Rockstar normally updates their games pretty regularly. Red Dead Online, for some reason, has sort of gotten the shorter end of the stick when it comes to updates and new features that the game has been introduced to due to various possible reasons, whether it's the crazy circumstances happening in the world right now, you know, like with the world feeling like it's ending, or just the fact that Red Dead Online just doesn't monetize as well as GTA 5 Online, and they're potentially working on bigger things in the GTA 5 Online world, which was confirmed recently as they are releasing the biggest update ever in history to GTA 5 Online. So, that could be a reason why some Red Dead Online stuff is sort of put on the back burner, but we don't exactly know. Rockstar is doing everything they can, in my opinion, to update the game in a timely manner to make it as entertaining as possible for us, the players. Now, whether or not they're doing a good job, that's for you and I to decide. I personally think they're doing their best. Their best may not be the best in my eyes. So come on, Rockstar, give us some better stuff, because right now we're sort of in a predicament. All right. We're in an entanglement, like Will Smith recently said. The new update, it's definitely not what we wanted or expected. I don't know if we set the bar too high with these expectations, or they just didn't really deliver anything that was super mind-blowing. That was like, oh my God, this is the best. I'm not sure. But the Naturalist role in itself is pretty, well, the money sucks. The mission sort of suck. A lot of it sort of sucks. But nevertheless, it is something to do that's different than what we were doing in the past. And it's actually pretty fun to do with friends and a posse. So if you guys have not seen my video where we showcase how to level up fast in Naturalist role that I posted, I believe, yesterday, make sure you guys check that out, because definitely an interesting situation. The Naturalist role in itself is pretty lackluster when it comes to your objective. Your objective is literally to just run around shooting your gun multiple times at animals until they fall asleep. I think in the future, Rockstar is going to do what they can to make some updates cool. With that said, here is some leaked imagery of the upcoming Halloween DLC that is literally just around the corner. So, first things first, I am absolutely in love with these images. The reason why is because it sort of showcases what the future can hold for Red Dead Online. So, as you guys can see, the first picture is of the horses. Now, this picture is definitely a weird one because it showcases the fact that Rockstar wants to add more cosmetics to horses as a whole. They want to do more things for the community to customize your horse, as there are things in the game right now to sort of make your horse your own, like braiding and some mass, like mine has a horn. There isn't really a lot of things you can do. Adding variations of colors and maybe possibly armor of some sort, where you can add multiple things to your horse to really make it distinguishable that this is your horse, and ultimately end up putting things in the game that you want to buy for your horse via real money so that they can go ahead and monetize Red Dead Online more, is ideal. Regardless, that is just the beginning. Next up, we have the very, very interesting, strange and supernatural, I guess, cosmetic items you can now, well, eventually purchase for your character. Now, there's two things here. This picture demonstrates not only what you can potentially wear and make your character sort of look like, but also new emotes that will be coming in the near future. This picture is a twofer. You sort of have like the cosmetic aspect and you also have the emote aspect to it. It's very interesting because Rockstar does a really good job at making things work for the circumstances of their game and the time period. I think Rockstar sort of shot themselves in the foot with Red Dead Online because, well, it's a little limited, especially with time. Next, because we have the brand new camera in Red Dead Redemption 2 and Red Dead Online, the advanced camera, I guess you could call it, we also will have like sort of sets you can set up to go ahead and take new pictures, which honestly, the photography community on Red Dead Online is pretty big. I know many of you guys at home may not be taking pictures constantly and love taking pictures and selfies, but there's actually a pretty tight-knit community on Red Dead Online for dope pictures, similar to how GTA 5 has the Snapmatic community. Red Dead Online also has this pretty cool community, especially because Red Dead Online in itself is just so beautiful. There's so many animals and things you can take pictures of, not only like selfies like in 2020, but there's actually cool things you can showcase in Red Dead Online that really make it like stand out comparatively. It's pretty cool. Next photo also teases emotes that are around the corner, which is like a growl and like, I guess a haunted look, like a I don't know what that was, but that's a pretty cool thing that you can do after different, I guess, limited time modes or last team standings. It's just like, hey, you know, a victory pose is an example of just like, hey, I just won this and this is my victory pose, especially during Halloween. It'd be a nice addition. But the one thing I'm most excited about when it comes to this Halloween update is this bad boy right here. This sword is so freaking cool. Now, here's the dilemma. I really feel like this sword is going to cost us an arm and a leg because it is dope. Like, it is so cool. It's possibly one of the coolest weapons that Rockstar could have ever introduced into Red Dead Online because, honestly, we don't have anything like this. There is not a single item that Rockstar has released that you can put on your person, besides, I guess, the new improved bow in the past I'm talking about, that is like, wow, this is dope. This is, you know, this is beautiful. This sword resembles that. It has like that really deathly feel to it and also just looks cool. Something you can just carry in your hand. It's super nice. So if Rockstar does start introducing new types of melee weapons that are customizable and or have different options to them, similar to like a customizable knife or customizable hatchet, customizable axe, all those features would be really, really cool to have in Red Dead Online. And I really hope they go down the path of customization. As you guys recently know, with the last Frontier Pass, they added accessories, rings, and things of that nature. They're going down a path that allows you as a player to make the player you're playing or the character you're playing feel more like it's yours. So once they do that, it's going to be a really, really great direction. And they continue doing this, I'm super stoked. Because we're not even close to being done about this new update of everything that just leaked. I don't even know how they got this stuff, by the way. Somehow, some way, they've unlocked some secrets. No idea, because normally this stuff does not leak like this, but this is a pretty big leak. Next up, we got this bar. Like, I don't know exactly where this is. This is clearly a bar somewhere that's been revamped to like a spooky feel, a strange and supernatural feel, with the torn rags on the roof and of course like the candles melting everywhere. It's honestly pretty cool. So if they have a whole like change of scenery for a lot of places and different things for this season, I'm all about it. So clearly they've been working on this for quite some time as we already have pictures. So some things are in the works and are right around the corner. Look for that. And lastly, of course, we have the different items that you can now buy, including the, I guess, the face mask. I'm not even sure what we would call it. Just like the bandages over the eyes, which we showcased earlier with the two like hobo looking people. So overall, dudes, I really believe Rockstar is making some good progress in a direction that all of us can agree is better than nothing. All right. I've gone by this for a while now, is that beggars can't be choosers. All right. At this point in this game's life cycle, we are pretty much on hands and knees begging for Rockstar to eventually give us content. They gave us content, and then as an internet community, a lot of people still weren't satisfied. You're on the internet, guys. A lot of times you're just not going to be satisfied, especially if you set your expectations so high. Live your life with low expectations and you'll always be satisfied. It's that simple. I'm super happy Rockstar's even keeping this game alive for the online community, most likely isn't monetizing as well as they may have wanted it to because they are limited in the time zone and of course because they have other priorities, which is GTA 5 right now, expanding that online for the new gen consoles, as well as potentially working on GTA 6 for the future years to come. So all in all, big thank you to all of you guys for all the continued support you guys have been showing all the videos that I post here. It's been absolutely nuts and I cannot thank you guys enough. So big thank you for all the love, especially on my Twitch as well, where I stream every single day. You guys can tune in to do GTA 5 mostly and sometimes Red Dead Online, depending on how I'm feeling. You guys can click here or here to go watch the next video, as this video you're currently watching is ending. So I'll see you guys on this video or on this video, because this one right now is coming to an end. I'll see you guys later with a brand new one. Click here or here to go watch the next one. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye, dudes. Go. Get out of here.